Hello, I would like to congratulate the organizing committee of this important Congress. For me, it's a great honor to participate in this session. In the next few minutes, I will present to you the technological evolution of water perfusion high-resolution esophageal manometry. My name is Carla Granja, and I have been working with digestive motility for over the last 20 years. Our motility laboratories in Brazil perform an average of 100 tests per month, in addition to the continuing education activities of physicians interested in this area. Recently, I'm proud and grateful to participate in the development of the Monhack Bariatric and Robotic Center Digestive Motility Laboratory in Indore, together with Dr. Manuel Galvão and Dr. Mohit Bandari, with the objective to giving diagnostic support to endoscopic and surgical procedures. But the great question is, why think about water perfusion system? As we know, solid state systems are the gold standard, but they are expensive. So the first challenge is cost effectiveness. In a country like Brazil, the cost of important equipment restricts the use of the high-resolution manometry to a few research centers. This is the main stimulus to investment in technology for the development of equipment equivalent with lower cost. So, the second challenge, develop the equipment equivalent in technology. And the third challenge, training physicians, high quality exams. And thus it makes feasible the modernization of digestive motility centers throughout the country. Our group is dedicated not only in this partnership of technological development, but to the training of physicians to perform high quality exams. Talking about technological evolution, since its emergence in the last century, water infusion manometry has undergone advances, and the high resolution manometry device we work on today presents some very interesting details. One of them is the probe's connection system to the device. The development of a single connector allows the rapid connection of the 36 channels probe with the high resolution manometry device, which features a closed system with electronic sensors and stainless steel capillaries that produce a less complacency perfusion system. Another advance is the continuous infusion pump, which allows the infusion of distilled water at a continuous and stable pressure. The infusion pressure is easily adjustable through the software. This mechanism does not require the use of old air pressurization tank. Another idea that was great is the fact that, different from the non-perfusion systems, the probe presents an intelligent distribution of sensors. We have here two areas of elliptical sensors positioned in a smaller interval, and it's permit to evaluate upper esophageal sphincter and especially esophagogastric junction actually. So we can see it's more sensible than probes that has sensors positioned just in longitudinal form. All images presented in the next slides are produced by exams we performed with this device. Here we can see the standard image at rest with the baseline period. In the proximal part of the graphic, we see the pressure impression of the upper esophageal sphincter. And in the distal part, we can see the pressure impression of the esophagogastric junction that respect the oscillation of the respiratory cycles. Here is the standard image in swelling. Pharynx, upper esophageal sphincter, and it's opening when we have the swelling. The proximal peristalsis, where predominates striated musculature, the cold break in the transition zone, and the distal peristalsis, where predominates smooth muscles. The esophageal gastric junction has a peculiar movement. When the opening of the pharynx, we have the relaxation and the flow through the esophageal gastric junction, and then we have an elevation of the pressure that is physiological and means the esophagogastric junction reaction post swelling. We can divide in first segment that includes pharynx, upper esophageal sphincter, and proximal esophagus. Second and third segments with medial esophagus and distal esophagus. And fourth segment that includes esophageal gastric junction movement during the swell. As proposed by the consensus, was conducted a multi-center prospective study to define specific normality parameters for this device. And we observed the REP of 16, very close to the observed by the Chicago group, which is 15. As we know, Chicago classification is a classification in evolution, and the last publication, the Chicago classification version 4.0, give to us the mission to do the exam in a protocol with two positions, supine and upright. But in the article, we can see this phrase. However, the protocol and classification can be performed with water perfused catheters if appropriate normative values are used, with the limitation of only supine swallows and maneuvers possible with water perfused manometry. From this publication, we feel again challenged to overcome this barrier, and the brief video that you will see below demonstrates, in summary, the result of a new technological advance. This video that you will see is a resume of an exam that we realized at a course that we did with researchers that are learning how to use this device in December of 2021. And here is the last part of the supine position. And you will see in the next part, in supine position, the contractile reserve, where we realize multiple rapid swallows to evaluate the contractile reserve. And then we click on an icon that means change of position. And the next image that you will see was not magic, and it's just mathematics, calculation, and evolution of the software. This is the defect of the water column pressure when you change the patient of the position. We wait to stabilize the position and the patient and the probe, and then we click change again, and the software calculates mathematics, the pressure, and dilate the effect of the column pressure water. Here we see the upright position. If you can observe, it's the same image that we have in the supine position without artifact of the changing of the position. And you will see during the swelling, and finally the rapid drink challenge. This patient was not a patient with dysphagia. It's just a patient that we are doing during a course, and the patient was very collaborative, and we perform all the protocol during the course. As I said before, it's not magic, it's only mathematic and technological evolution of the software. We perform all the protocol proposed by the Chicago classification 4.0. We do 3 deep inspirations to document the correct position of the probe to start the position of the data. We do the rest baseline, 60 seconds for a baseline stabilization, and collect the rest pressure. Then we do 10 wet swellings with 5 ml with 30 second interval between the swelling. And then we perform the multiple wrapped swallows test to evaluate the quantitative reserve. This is the image of a positive test when we just do one sample. And when we have this image with a failed test, we realized a minimum of 3 samples of the test to do a report that there is an absence of contractile reserve. Then we repeat all the phases in the upright position, the deep inspirations, the rest pressure, and this is the image of the upright position, the wet swellings. And then we finally perform the rapid drink challenge with 200 ml of water. This is the image of a normal REP. And here the goal is to evaluate the REP. Here is an image of an esophagogastric junction in the supine position with the alteration of the REP over 16, that is our value of normality to this matrix. Here is in the upright position the confirmation of the alteration of the REP, and here is the image of the rapid drink challenge in the same patient. In a patient with achalasia, we have pump pressurization in supine position. Then it's the same thing that we see in the upright position, the alteration of the REP over 16, and the pump pressurization documented. And here is the image of the worse pressurization with a bigger volume of water in rapid drink challenge. So Chicago classification 4.0 supine and upright protocol performed with water perfusion high resolution esophageal manometry is possible, is feasible. It involves high technological quality, and for us is better cost effectiveness. I am very proud to participate of the evolution of this history. Thank you very much.